Dr. Mindy here, and on this video, we're going to talk about dry fasting and how it relates to brain health. So if you are new to my channel, I just want to say welcome. I hope you find everything you want to find about fasting on this channel. I am a woman on a mission to get 1 million people fasting this year. So I'm excited you're here. I hope you learn everything you need to learn through my videos, through the science, through the application that I'm teaching you guys. Hit the notification button, hit the subscribe button, and you'll get notified when I go live. Again, I think you'll find a lot of goodness here when it comes to learning how to fast. And those of you that share my fasting videos, just adore you, appreciate you, love being on this journey with you. Okay, it's fast training week. If you don't know what that is, once a month, we take a 5-day period and we practice a different fast. So this week, we are practicing dry fasting. No food, no water, but we're doing it Ramadan style, which means we can have water and coffee before the sun comes up. We go 12 hours, no food, no water. And then after the sun goes down, you're gonna eat a ketobiotic meal. If you don't know what any of that is, just go ahead and go back to the video before this and the video, the couple of videos before this, and you will find all the instructions, or just put companion guide in your comments and my team will send you a link with the companion guide where you can also win a free box of Element, which is amazing minerals for fasters. They sponsor our fast training week. Okay, brain health. I actually think this is why I like to dry fast. And I didn't even realize that the first time I discovered dry fasting was really as you do a longer fast, like a 3-day water fast. As the days go on, you don't want to drink water. And you start to see that your brain clarity gets better and better and better. Well, it turns out that that's what the research says. So when you go, and this was again done on Ramadan style fasting, when you go without food and water, 12 to 24 hours a day for 30 days, this is what they see in brain health. There will be an increase in neuron protection against degeneration. So this is great for people with dementia, Alzheimer's, memory loss, people who are trying to prevent that, or maybe you're in the beginning stages of it. We also know that dry fasting, Ramadan style, will create new neurons. Okay, remember, neurons are carrying information in your brain. You've got trillions of them. The more, the better when it comes to neurons. Okay, third thing that dry fasting will do is that it will increase brain plasticity. So here's the thing with brain plasticity. This has to do with how capable these neurons are to transmit information. Brain plasticity is a great thing. When your brain becomes, like in an Alzheimer's situation, when it becomes, it degenerates, what that's happening is it becomes rigid. So we want it to be plastic and flexible. And then the last one is that you will see a decreased, oh, this is fascinating, decreased neuronal excitement. Okay, so what does that mean? That means that you make new neurons, you repair the old ones, but these neurons are not as amped up in like a stress situation. Neuronal excitement happens like when the amygdala is firing at you and saying, you're not safe, there's a problem. That's when the neurons are firing too quick in an anxious state. But what dry fasting will do is it'll calm those neurons down. That's awesome. Okay, so why does it do this? And here's what I wanna really point out to you is that if we go back to the primal reason that dry fasting works, is you were designed to thrive and get stronger without food. And what we're learning is that you were actually designed to thrive and get stronger without water for short periods of time. If we go back to cave people, they came out of the cave, they didn't always have water. So our brains had to be able to go 12 to 24 hours without water. And we needed something to make our brains even sharper so we could go find water to stay alive. So what your brain does is it makes a neurotransmitter called BDNF. And BDNF is like fertilizer for the brain. And what it will do, and dry fasting does this better than any other fast, what BDNF has been known to do is it maintains memory and learning. So as you age, if you throw some of these dry fasts in, it's going to improve your memory. It's going to improve your learning capability. We also know that it'll regenerate neurons. So that's great, because as you age, these neurons are starting to degenerate. And we also know that it will stimulate proteins in the brain that are responsible for adaptation when there is little food available. Okay, that's fascinating, because what that tells me is that it might make, I have no evidence, I'm just taking the research and putting in an application, so you guys will have to tell me, that if you throw some dry fasts in here or there, that it might make you more adaptable to some of the other water fasting that you're doing. So BDNF, the only other way to get BDNF is through exercise, which is awesome, it's great, but dry fasting is better than all the other fasts for BDNF. Okay, so why does this work? Well, I just talked about what happens in the caveman days, but let's just be very clear that dry fasting, it works because it's another level of stress. So when you're fasting and you take food out of the equation, but you're drinking, that's one level of stress. But now when you take water out of the equation for a short period of time, you have added in another layer of stress that the body will adapt positively. Now, if you're hearing this for the first time and you're like, this is crazy, I want you to remember that short bouts of stress improve us. When we are not stressed, that is how the human body and brain starts to degenerate. When we have moments of stress, like anybody who's done an exercise program where they've pushed themselves knows this, that you always keep pushing yourself so that the body keeps adapting. Well, the same thing with fasting. This could be another level of just pushing you right to the edge so that your brain will adapt and your body will adapt more favorably. So what kind of conditions, mental conditions, would you use dry fasting for? And I really think that there's two. The mood disorders, specifically depression. When I dove into the research a little bit more, it showed that dry fasting, because of this neuronal repair, because of BDNF production, can be really incredible for depression. So I'm kind of curious from you guys, as you go through this week, let me know how you feel. We're doing 5 days of dry fasting, Ramadan style. Tell me how it works for you. Do you notice more happiness? Do you notice more mental clarity? I can tell you when I dry fast, the answer is absolutely yes. And then the other place, because of the BDNF's power on neurons, that I would use this would be, I would throw it into your fasting variation if you're having some memory issues. So losing memory, losing keys, trying to find stuff, you can't remember people's names, maybe throwing in 5 days like we're doing now of dry fasting could be really cool. So those are your options. Remember, you always want to be safe when you dry fast. It's no food, no water. So we always want to be safe. 12 to 24 hours is the max that I encourage you to go. Always check your numbers. And again, if you guys want all these resources, just put companion guide in the comments and my team will send you a link for that. If you are intrigued by dry fasting, go back and watch the video I did on can dry fasting allow you to burn more fat. That's the video before this. It's pretty interesting what the research is showing on that. But for moods, for memory, dry fasting, it actually might be that one fast you need to just slip into your rotation so you can improve cognition and you can make sure that your brain is getting stronger, not just your body. So as always, if you have a personal experience with dry fasting, specifically when it comes to memory, put it in the notes. If you want the companion guide, put companion guide in there. You can win some free element in the companion guide they sponsor this week. But never give up on yourself. You have so many miracles happening in here. And when we take food and water out of the equation, those miracles can reveal themselves. So as always, I hope that helps.